welcome back to AfricanRising.com. My name is Ayek, and this is my blog. If you're new to African Rising, thank you so much for stopping by. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you're feeling me. You know what I'm saying? And if you're returning, mwah, thank you so much for all of your love. I don't know, was that supposed to be me blowing a kiss? Anyway, thank you so much for all the love and the support. I really appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. So today I have a quick story time, just, you know, a little embarrassing thing that I did years and years ago. Well, it wasn't that long ago. It was like, yeah, like 5 or 6 years ago. Let's look at a couple of my old pictures and then we'll get to why we're here. Okay, let me grab my laptop because I don't want to like use my phone. Okay, let me just get my laptop. So here we have a picture of me. I remember, I think I was, oh, it has to have been more than 5 years ago. I'm pretty sure I was in the 10th grade. Y'all, I was so pressed to take this photo. I could not stop thinking about the picture all day in class. Like, I was just so pressed to take it. This is supposed to be like a model, like Vogue-esque type of vibe. Okay, this was me. I was just excited that I got a webcam on, like, you know, those mini laptops. So I was like taking, you know, my model pictures once again. And I also, this is my first NARS lipstick. I don't remember the shade. I don't remember anything about it, but it was my first NARS lipstick and I was very, very, very excited. And I had to share with the world, and the caption even said NARS $14.95. Like, what? And everybody looked at the picture and they were like, we don't understand. Are you NARS? Like, are you for sale? And here we have more like a chill, you know, like smile, sexy kind of vibe. You know, I was doing it, or at least I thought I was doing it. And then here we have like post-braid, you know, when you take out your braids and your hair just feels super long. And I had just recently gone natural around that time. So I was really hyped to have some length. So, you know, I had to pop the selfie out, you know what I'm saying? And this definitely was senior year because I wore this shirt at least once a week. Like, I'm a creature of habit, so I don't mind wearing like the same thing. So I literally wore this shirt until there were holes in it. So all of these pictures are nice, right? They're really cute, like especially the last one, they're gorgeous. But despite that, I didn't feel comfortable enough showing my picture to my crush. So when Tumblr first came out, my sister had mentioned it, but I was like, no, I'm not into it or whatever. I didn't really understand it. But shortly after, I was like, no, I need to get a Tumblr. So I set up my Tumblr. I was, you know, reblogging. I was so hyped. You know, it just felt like a mini, I don't know what it felt like a mini blog, but it also felt like this kind of community feel. So on Tumblr, I don't know if they still have this on Tumblr because Tumblr has just turned into something else that I don't know too much about because I'm old. You know, I'm saying I'm 23. I'm old. So Tumblr had these things, like these little communities. So there was Africans killing it, Nigerians killing it, this and the third. And, you know, like people would post, they would like send in their submissions. And, you know, that's where you could, you know, see who the cuties were or whatever the case may be. So it was this one little cutie. He was cute. He was a cutie. Now looking back, he wasn't that much of a cutie, but at the time, because my taste has changed, like, I'm sorry. I mean, now looking back, he wasn't really hitting. Not worth doing what I did, but at the time, he was so fine to me. So I would go on his Tumblr, I was like going on every day. It's like, oh my gosh, I want him to be mine, he gotta be my man. So I finally get the courage to send him a message on, or ask a question on Tumblr, because Tumblr has a feature where you can ask a question but ask it anonymously, and they can respond privately or like on their page. So I asked him a couple of questions, like, you know, said a couple of things, asked a couple of questions, and then he like realized our conversation, like we weren't talking about like, oh, I'm trying to do you and stuff. We were not talking about freaky stuff. But, like, we just realized that there was, like, a connection kind of thing. So it was like, okay, like, let's, if you don't want to tell me who you are, like, let's still just talk privately. And privately meant, like, he would answer the questions or respond to me without posting it to the public. So, and by the public, I mean his followers. So, you know, like, we kept talking and stuff like that. And he was like, oh, yeah, well, I live in Atlanta. And I'm like, oh, I live in Maryland or whatever. We're both from, actually, I think he was from Cross River. He was Nigerian. He was from South, I think he was from Cross River. I don't think he was from the same state as I am, but I'm pretty sure it was Cross River. So, you know, we had that kind of, like, connection, too, or whatever. So, he's like, yeah, you know, like, you're cool. Like, you know, I'm feeling you, or whatever the case may be. Like, what's up with you? Can we talk, like, on the phone, or can we text? Like, you don't have to, like, we don't have to talk on the phone, but can we at least have some sort of, like, conversations off of Tumblr? Because, you know, like, neither of us can respond as quickly as we would have liked. So I was like, okay, I didn't know it was going to come to this. I didn't foresee this. I, didn't know it was going to get this deep. So I was like, no, I really feel more comfortable with us just talking on here. And he's like, okay, cool, whatever. So we're talking and stuff like that. He's like, you know, like, you see my face all the time on my Tumblr. I really want to put a name to a face. I was like,
what? You want me to send you a picture of me?
Now, naturally, it's like a no-brainer, right? If I'm comfortable with sending a picture, I should send it, you know, say, hey, like, here's my picture. If I'm not comfortable, I should say, hey, no, I don't want to send you my picture. But I was like, let me just do it. And the thing is that it didn't even occur to me to say no. I was just like, okay, I need to send something. So I went through Tumblr, and you know, you have your little Tumblr crushes, your little girl crushes, or whatever. Or I had my girl crushes on Tumblr. I'm like, oh my gosh, she's so gorgeous. She's perfect. She's this, she's that. So there's this one, I guess she was a young lady. She's a little older than me. And she was like, she was gorgeous. I was like, oh my gosh, she's like a natural beauty. She's who I wish I looked like. And I copy and pasted her picture and saved it. And I was like, oh, here's my picture. Because eventually, oh, I forgot to mention this. Eventually, I came off of Anonymous and we were just talking back and forth. So I sent the picture and he was like, oh, okay, cool. Like, you're gorgeous. That's what he said. I was like, oh, yeah, I got him now. He's going to pay my bride price. But, like, it didn't occur to me, ma'am, that's not you. So what? Whose bride price is he really paying? He ain't going to be paying yours. So 2 or 3 days went by and I didn't hear from him. Like, usually he would send a message or something. So I was like, what's going on? Well, I went on his Tumblr page and he had a recent post. And the post title was, y'all, I really got cat. I really just got catfish or something like, I just got catfish for the first time or something like that. And I was like, my heart, like, sunk. Like, I was scared. I don't know what I thought he was going to do. I don't know if I thought he was going to call the police on me or whatever, but I was so scared. So I was like, I'm just not going to say anything. It's going to be quiet. Well, he posted that. Then he posted a few other things like, I can't believe that, you know, people are really out here doing this, you know, whatever. I don't know what he's talking about. He just had like a whole bunch of other posts. Now, it gets worse. So the woman or the young lady that I sent the picture of and said it was me is actually his friend. And I went on her Tumblr and she's like, wow, it's my first time ever getting catfish. You know, I'm feeling like, you know, I'm feeling good or whatever, which I guess she was like, it was like a boost to her ego that people were pretending to be her. So after that situation, he didn't block me, but I was like, there's no point in sending any more messages. Like, just walk away, just go away with your tail between your legs and leave it at that. So at the time, like, it was so scary. Like, for weeks after, I was still terrified. I don't know what I thought, but I ended up deleting my Tumblr, like, immediately after that because I was like, oh my gosh, like, I don't know if I thought the FBI was going to come for me or whatever. So, at that point, I think that, I don't know, I don't want to say it was a turning point because it kind of wasn't. I still, you know, struggled with self-esteem, and I still sometimes do, but definitely then, that was kind of rock bottom for me. I look back at it, and I was like, wow. The issue was like, I'm disgusting. I'm not it. I don't have the look. And he might not want that, so I need to pretend to be somebody else. At the time, yeah, I posted those pictures, and, you know, I had my moments where I was like, oh, yeah, I am cute. Like, I'm feeling my look. But generally, my perception of myself was really, 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 really poor. And I looked at myself as, like I said, somebody who's disgusting, somebody who's not worthy of love or, like, to be pursued or whatever the case may be. And I mean, like, consensual pursuit, not, like, stalking or anything like that. So, that situation, I mean, it was one of many things that kind of showed me that something was going to have to give. I was just going to have to address my confidence issues. Around that time, I always told myself, you know, which is why I use the young lady that I use in the picture, because I'm like, well, maybe like 5 or 10 years I'll look like her or kind of like her. And when I do look like her, then I can start sending, you know, if I'm talking to somebody or if I'm talking to a guy and he says, send me a picture, then I can send my picture. But right now, no, girl, you don't have the look, so just do what you can. So that is the story of how I catfished my crush. I hope you guys enjoyed this short little story. I hope that you're able to take something away from it. And this story is so embarrassing for me. Like, it's so embarrassing for me to say that I catfished someone, but it is what it is. Like, it's a part of my story. It's a part of my journey. So I want to know one of two things, or you can actually tell me both. Have you ever catfished someone and, like, gotten caught? Like, that's the thing. To catfish and get caught is, like, ridiculous. But have you ever catfished someone and gotten caught? Or, like, what is the most embarrassing thing you've done? Like, okay, let me not say ever. Like, the past 5 or 10 years in your life. Now, if you're not comfortable sharing with me, you can actually click the link below, or there's going to be a link in my bio. A friend of mine actually came up with this cool concept of anonymous confessions, and essentially what it is it's meant to be a safe space for you to share something that you wouldn't tell anyone else, something that you feel uncomfortable with, or maybe you could just say, like, I thought there was a bug in my room. Maybe it's just you saying, oh, I love AX. She's awesome. Like, she's cool. Like, you can use the platform for anything, but it's intended to be a safe space. And it's, to some degree, meant to be therapeutic. Feel free to click that link. Make that confession. I haven't made my confession yet because I don't got anything to hide. And if I got to make a confession, I'm going to turn on my camera. Then I'm going to upload it to youtube.com/AfricanRising. What's up? Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you'll enjoy my, it's not really a tutorial, it's just like my every, not my everyday, but like my go-to makeup look video. So hopefully those will be up sometime this month or sometime this year, sometime in 2017. You know what I'm saying? Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you all. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Peace!